Hi, this is Casual Fridays and I'm Tuja Harmonix. Today's guest is Lebohang Monyatsi, also known as Lee L. Lee, I discovered you on Facebook and I saw you upload videos and you're a model, and I was quite interested to interview you. Could you explain to us about your modeling and your brand Pretty Wheels, hashtag Pretty Wheels?
Okay, thank you so much for the opportunity. Pretty Wheels is actually pretty on wheels, so I just shortened it up. It's pretty on wheels I'm capable, because most of the time people, you know, will be coming to me and say, oh my god, you're so pretty, how can you be in a wheelchair? You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and they think that you are only pretty lady in a wheelchair who cannot do anything, hence yes. Pretty on wheels, I'm capable.
Yes. Tell us a bit about your modeling.
I'm a model at MCP Models. The guy just discovered me and he wants to like spread awareness about people with disability,
mm-hmm.
that they can be models, they can be actors and actresses.
Yes,
and I'm also an aspiring actress. I got a role on one of the movies. The name is Matters of the Heart. It's not a huge role, but it's a beginning of a dream, something that I've been dreaming about.
So what are your challenges, seeing that now you want to aspire as a model, actress, and all your other dreams? What are the challenges that you faced thus far?
The challenges that I've experienced as an aspiring actress or a model is that most agencies don't want to expose or hire people who have disabilities. Mm. For example, I once applied to a certain agency and the response was, I'm sorry, I won't have any job for you because of the wheels. I mean, the wheels doesn't define who I am, or the wheels doesn't define my capabilities.
Yes.
I only use them for mobility. Yes, I'm capable of doing anything like everybody else. At the moment, I'm working with a very intelligent team. We're working on a documentary that will include people with disabilities who aspire to be actresses, actors, mm. or modeling.
Mm-hmm.
We will dismantle or get rid of the stereotypes that people have about people with disabilities.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And we'll be interviewing different kind of people who are living with disability. Maybe we'll be one of them as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you saying when you go for an audition or you go for casting or for a magazine shoot, when you say you're looking for models, it shouldn't be defined by disability, it should be just a person. So if you're going for an action role, you should just rock up there with your wheelchair, it doesn't matter. You go there.
Of course, it will be very nice, and I really appreciate that if we can be defined
mm.
by our capabilities,
yes.
not by our crutches, yes. our wheelchairs, or our walking sticks, you understand it?
Yeah.
I can, even an action movie, I can just walk up and do whatever they want me to do, you understand?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, because why would they have to choose an able-bodied person to play a person with disability on a wheelchair, where they could have just hired an actress or actor that's on a wheelchair? But that doesn't mean that they have to always pick that person for that role. I'm not saying now TV must not say, we are looking for a person on a wheelchair, no.
Yes.
It's true what you say, you have to go for the audition just as you are, for your capabilities.
Yes, and what they do, you know, they portray us as, or like when they do their movies,
mm.
or they are so pissed, they portray us as a burden.
Yes.
Pity, you know, or heroes for obtaining my degree, I'm a hero. For going to work, I'm a hero.
Mm.
Do you say that to anyone who has obtained the degree that they are inspiring?
No.
I mean, I just live a normal life like anybody else.
Exactly.
I'm not an inspiration. Don't call me an inspiration if I get every morning and go to work like everybody else. Shouldn't I be doing that?
Exactly.
You know?
There should be more bad guys, like people in the world just playing bad guys and...
Exactly. Exactly. Yeah. Mm. Don't portray us as people who are a burden to a society, because mm. that's how society takes us.
Exactly.
Media has a huge influence on society.
Lee, can you please explain to us about your type of disability and from when did you ever growing up as a child? What were your challenges? Please tell us your story. Yeah.
I had polio at the age of 3. I grew up with it. And the challenges that one will have as a polio survivor is that you cannot like play like any other kids, and sometimes they run. Most people who have polio, they limp and they can't run very fast. So they'll be playing there, they run, and we're sitting there, you know, isolated and all that. But I was fortunate enough because I went to a special school where people understood each other. Mm-hmm. So there I was able to get along with everybody and play with everybody. We have different kind of disabilities. Initially, I thought I wouldn't be able to fit into a mainstream school because of how people stared at me, because of how they teased me. And of course, the teachers at mainstream school, they don't really understand how to deal with different disabilities like teachers in special schools.
Yes.
Because those teachers are trained to deal with people with disabilities.
Yeah.
But right now, I think that every teacher should be trained to deal with people with disabilities, because we're trying to promote the inclusion.
Mm.
And when people with different abilities start attending mainstream schools, people will get used to them. People will not stay anymore.
Definitely.
Yeah. Mm. And the challenges that I've experienced, it was at university. Most varsities, okay, maybe now they're starting to transform. But while I was at varsity, I had a challenge of access.
Yes.
They had no accessible features.
Yeah.
So my classes were upstairs.
Yeah.
And most of the time, the lifts were not working. But fortunately enough, people were very helpful. The guys will come and pick me up, and others will come will come with my wheelchair, you know? Yeah, those kind of things. People are really helpful out there.
Lee, if there's anything in the world that you could change in a split second, if you had the ability to just change it, anything in the world, what would it be?
If there could be anything that I could change in the world, it will be like in varsities where we have everybody. There's people with disabilities, there's normal people. I like it to be like that with every school.
Mm.
You understand? And for the media industry to treat us like everybody else, not to pity us, not to take us as like we are burdens, not to treat us like we want special treatment.
Mm.
You understand? Yeah.
Thank you, Lee. Catch us next Friday for Casual Fridays with Tuja Harmonics.